We have with us Ms. Rama Veda Shree, CEO of Data Security Council of India. Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
How was your experience at the One Day Conference on the FinTech and Future of Money?
I think it was a very good team that the BSC Institute has put together, and very good themes across the sessions, particularly, you know, whether integrating concepts of security, blockchain, and all the emerging technologies. And even I see a very good diverse mix of speakers.
Okay, ma'am. How are we improving data privacy posture in the consumer environment?
I think it's a long journey, and there is beginning to be enough focus in terms of data protection and privacy, particularly in the financial services world. We are beginning to see a lot of focus in terms of privacy programs and privacy best practices in the banks, and of course the new league of payment banks. But I think we need to do a lot more in terms of end user awareness and making sure that the solution providers start using basic principles of privacy and privacy by design principles.
Ma'am, I also want to know, how is India's digital payment secured?
I think digital payments, it is really leapfrogging in India. It is a collective responsibility. On one hand, we have the regulator, which has the cybersecurity framework, which is the RBI cybersecurity framework for financial services institutions. And then there is a national cybersecurity policy. There are agencies like the CERTIN, which also looks at any incidents that happen. I think currently there is a lot of, relatively there's more maturity in the financial services world, where, and the technology industry servicing that also we see a lot of maturity. But definitely given the threat landscape and the kind of attacks that we are beginning to witness, it is extremely important we scale up the cybersecurity preparedness of the entire ecosystem which is servicing the fintech domain.
So are there any challenges and how we are going to resolve it?
Challenges are there because the cybersecurity attacks are becoming more and more complex. There are state actors, there are insider risks, and there could be hacktivists. So the attack and the attackers and the attack vectors, and today I even talked about, you know, crime as a service. So there are so many such challenges. I think the way we can get prepared is continuously be aware of the risks, invest in the right technologies and the people and the process capability, and not only invest in defending, but also invest in threat intelligence and invest in the threat intelligence platforms so that you not only stay aware at what is happening within your enterprise, but at your sectoral level, at a country level, and a global level.
Ma'am, you spoke about threat service may expand. So what are your intakes on that?
Yes, I think the threat surface not may, it is already expanded, because previously most financial services used to happen in a brick and mortar environment or online, which was more about, you know, your banking web-based solutions. Whereas now most financial services transactions are happening on the mobile. It can be also through smart wearables, and there are a lot of point of sale devices which are getting provisioned. So you have the entire threat landscape expanding right from the cloud to the end consumer's devices.
How AI can protect fintech from cyber threats?
AI has extremely good applications in terms of security solutions. There is a lot of innovation that is happening in leveraging AI and machine learning, and the entire threat intelligence platforms that are getting built leveraging AI. And AI and machine learning is core to innovating on cybersecurity solutions.
Thanks a lot, ma'am. Thanks for your mindful insights.
Thank you.